This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Toyota Corolla. Let's lead the way. Once upon a time, a pregnant woman wanted strawberries. When she didn't get them, her daughter was born a few months later with a strawberry-shaped mark on her forehead. Or so the story goes in much of ancient history. Yet the true origins of birthmarks are a little less weird. Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. Birthmarks can often be a source of embarrassment for some. A mistake of DNA can lead to a deposit of melanin or a tangle of veins, but surprisingly, not a lot is known about them. Scientists split birthmarks into two main categories, vascular and pigmented. Caused by an increase in melanin in one spot, pigmented birthmarks are mostly harmless. Moles, cafe au lait, and Mongolian spots are the three big kinds. Pigmented nevi, or more commonly known as moles, they're dark skin cells that grow in clusters. Cafe au lait are a little more spread out and a little lighter brown or tan. Mongolian spots are a bluish-purple color and appear when melanocytes get trapped in a deeper layer of the skin, and they're typically found in people of East Asian descent. They go away as kids get older and are almost always gone by puberty. More is known about vascular birthmarks, however. The most common are stork bites. They're pink or tan patches that appear on baby's neck. It's estimated that as many as half of all newborns get one. Similar to spider veins, the stretching of some capillaries causes the patches to appear, and they too usually go away after about 18 months or so. Another type of common birthmark are little strawberry-like marks called infantile hemangiomas. These are basically benign tumors in the cells that line blood vessels. One study published in the Journal of Clinical Investigation found that these marks originate in one type of cell which expresses a protein, CD133. From these cells, blood vessels form, but then they disappear, leaving behind fat cells which make the marks stick out. Another study published in the Pediatric Dermatology found a connection between oxygen depletion in the placenta and the development of these type of birthmarks. Yet some research from the Medical College of Wisconsin and Children's Research Institute suggests that low birth weight is the single greatest factor in developing an infantile hemangioma. Most of these disappear after a few months, but up to 10% of them can cause some problems, like getting so big it impacts vision or breathing. And some birthmarks indicate a serious underlying issue. Port wine birthmarks are pretty common. About 1 million people in the United States have their reddish elevated spots. Like stork bites and hemangiomas, they form when capillaries don't grow correctly. Yet these can grow and thicken over time. They can sometimes be a hallmark of Sturge-Weber syndrome, in which patients have abnormal blood vessels in the skin, brain, and eyes, which can cause the symptoms of the disorder. One study published in the New England Journal of Medicine found a single genetic mutation in the gene, GNAQ, is associated with the disorder. From this rundown, it's clear more research is needed, so get on it, science! Alright guys, do you have a weird birthmark? Let us know in the comments below. While you're at it, don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back here for new episodes every day of the week. This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Toyota Corolla. Let's lead the way.